Rod Serling. You're listening to The Zero Hour. Rest your eyes. Exercise your imagination. Today, Kim Weisskopf's overview of an underground newspaper ad. Wanted it. Starring William Shatner. In a Mutual Broadcasting System presentation of The Zero Hour.
Brought to you by the Ford Motor Company, Shenley Industries, Matus Wine, Beechnut Chewing Tobacco, and Dial Soap. This is The Zero Hour on Mutual Radio.
Want ads are often misleading, especially those under the heading personals. Mike Matthews responded to one and now finds himself in an awkward position. Pay blackmail or be exposed, but there's hope. Private Detective Steve Terrell is on the case, and Terrell just loves his work. In fact, he's even placed an ad of his own. The copy begins, Wanted, a willing companion, which incidentally is the title of today's story.
Hey, Matthews. Over here. Thought you might have forgotten. Not a chance. Yeah, sit down. What are you drinking?
I'm not. Did you bring it?
You bring the money?
Let's have the photographs first. Where are the negatives?
Well, you didn't really think I'd bring them here.
Listen, Pomerantz, or whatever your name is, you played out your string. This is the last money I can raise.
Look, we're not putting the bite on you for any more. Not now, anyway. But I will take what you brought. Yeah, it's all here. Well, I could at least spring for a drink. What'll you have?
Just stay away from me, Pomerantz. You and that girl both.
Now, behave yourself, Matthews. Oh, and say hello to the wife and kids.
Hi, Mike. How'd it go?
I paid the bloodsucker like you said to Steve, but
good. Go on home. I'll take it from here.
What are you going to do?
It's done.
What do you mean it's done? Pomerantz still has the negatives.
Read this. The one circled in red ink. Pomerantz and his lady friend have got themselves a new boy.
Wanted. A willing companion for weekend rendezvous.
Of fun and games. Straight, well-endowed businessman looking for free-thinking woman, 25 to 35, to share capital gains.
Well, sounds like a winner, Maggie.
He sounded filthy rich over the phone. I'm meeting him for dinner tomorrow.
Now, just make sure you don't go where you might run into Matthews. You know, I'm against doing this twice in one city.
But this town is crawling with ringers. These street sheets are full of them. Look, why don't you lay off Matthews if he puts you uptight? Starting tomorrow, we'll concentrate on this one. Mr. Steve Thompson.
So, my wife won't suspect I'm bringing some paperwork along. You won't mind.
Only if you work on it, Steve.
You're very forward, Miss Pearson.
Well, your ad said free-thinking woman. And please, call me Cindy.
All right, then. Cindy, I'll pick you up at 4 o'clock Friday. Where do you live?
Oh, not my place, Steve. My boyfriend is not a free-thinking man.
Whoa.
I'll meet you.
Where?
Well, how about here?
All right. Gosh, this is really exciting. I've never done this before.
Oh, neither have I.
Here's your check, sir.
Will any of these suffice?
I'm sorry, sir. We don't honor credit cards.
Oh, well, that's all right. I'll take cash.
Keep the change.
Thank you, sir. Have a pleasant evening. Shall we? Cindy? Shall we go?
Oh, of course. Vic! Vic!
Yeah, I hear you.
Oh, Vic, this one's too good to be true.
Yeah? Well, you better be careful of him, then.
No, I mean it. Thompson's as timid as they come. His wife walks all over him.
Then we gotta watch out for her.
Oh, stop being such a cynic. I had the meal of a lifetime tonight. The bill was over $50, and he paid for it in cash.
Well, he'd better get used to it.
And he tossed down the bourbon pretty good, too, so we shouldn't have any problem knocking him out. You got the film?
Oh, yeah, miles of it. Now, where are you going to be?
I'm meeting him Friday at 4. We'll be driving up to his private cabin near Idlewild. I got the directions.
Oh, yeah, yeah, this is good. Now, I'll go up ahead of you and sort of drop in Friday night.
Vic, Saturday night's fine with me. Even with his glasses, he's kind of cute.
Terrell here.
Steve, it's Mike. What happened?
Well, it's all shit. What took you so long to call?
It's family night. I had to take Diane and the boys to the movies.
Mm-hmm.
We just got back. Hurry, I don't want her to get suspicious.
Well, I'm a little bummed.
Steve, will you tell me what happened?
A friend of mine has a cabin in the mountains, so stop by my office tomorrow and I'll give you directions. I already gave them to the girl to pass along.
You think she went for it?
Mike, you missed an Academy Award performance.
I'll be sure not to miss the next one.
Mike, who's that?
It's Steve Terrell, private eye extraordinaire.
Yes, Frank. Next time you have a show on the air, call me sooner. It's Frank Baser.
There's a rehearsal in my office at 10 in the morning. Can you make it?
Who's Frank Baser?
He's a writer friend of mine.
Mike?
Oh, sure, Frank. I wouldn't miss it for the world.
Okay, I'm passing out now. Bye.
Mike, go up and say goodnight to the boys.
Sure, in a minute.
Is something the matter?
No, why?
You just seem nervous lately.
Well, it's business, honey. I've got this impossible new account.
Can I do anything to help?
No. I should have the deal closed by Monday.
Steve? Over here on the couch.
What are you doing?
Not so loud. My head is an echo chamber.
What'd you do, sleep here?
How can you tell?
Ooh. Well, let's get to it. I'm late for work.
Okay. These are the directions. Will you be able to get away Friday night?
Yeah, I told Diane I have a late business dinner, so I'm covered until about 10.
That's long enough if these people work fast.
Well, they do.
I'll let the girl drug me, see, and then Pomerantz comes in and takes his pictures, and the two of them leave. And you follow them back to town and see where they go. You think you can do that?
What happens to you?
Oh, I get several hours of blissful, drug-induced sleep and meet you back here Saturday morning. Don't you go in after those two. You're paying me to do that. Mike?
Yeah?
You got any aspirin?
My Steve. You certainly like your bourbon.
Well, I'm just a little nervous.
Steve, come here. Drink up and we'll... How did you put it? Share the wealth.
Gosh, Cindy, I don't know.
Don't you like me, Steve?
Sure, I like you. It's just...
Well, drink your drink and then Cindy's going to show you how a free-thinking woman has a good time.
There. Hey, what are you doing?
Taking off your shirt.
What for?
Well, don't be scared.
I'll take off my own shirt if you don't mind.
All right. In that case...
Hey, wait. What are you doing there?
I'm taking off my clothes. Or would you rather do it?
No. I'm a little dizzy. I'll turn out the lights. Oh, Cindy?
Yes? Poor Steve. Vic!
All right, get ready. I'll put him on the bed. Yeah, get his pants and shoes off. I'll set up the camera.
What should I do with his glasses?
Well, does he wear them all the time?
I think so.
Well, then put him on them, then. We don't want his wife to think it's somebody else. You ready?
How's this?
Yeah, that's good. Now, hold that pose. Now, roll him over. Yeah, that's good.
This is always worth plenty.
No. I can't see his face. There. Hold it there. Good. We got enough. Now get your clothes on.
Look at him. Is that a face a mother could love?
Come on. Let's go.
Oh, wait a minute. My ring. I must have dropped it somewhere.
Forget the ring.
Forget you.
Well, I'm not sticking around here.
Oh, go on. I'll get home. Steve might have to hitchhike, but that's the way it goes.
All right, but don't be long. You hear me, Maggie?
Just develop the film. I can take care of myself.
Wake up, Terrell. The honeymoon's over.
Go away.
Sorry, old buddy, but I can't. It's me, Lester.
Go away, Lester.
Lester? What are you... Hey, what time is it?
3 a.m.
Three in the morning?
You want us to move to Bonnie, Lieutenant?
Not yet.
Lester? Did he say body?
Sure did. And it looks better than yours, even with a hole in it.
Hmm?
You look pretty funny with nothing on but socks and glasses. Since when are you nearsighted?
Hold on, Lester. I can explain.
Who's the girl, Steve? Friend of yours? A client, maybe?
No. She's a blackmailer.
Not anymore. She's not. Who's your client, Steve?
You know I can't tell you that, Lester.
Gotta take you in, then.
Lester, can I ask you for a favor?
Ask.
Turn me loose. I'll bring you the killer inside of 24 hours.
Can't do that, Steve.
Yeah, I know.
You didn't kill her, did you, Steve?
Lester, really?
Sorry, I had to ask. We found the murder weapon in the room. It's registered to you.
Well, you better pull over then, Lester.
Can't do that, Steve.
Hate to tell you this, old buddy, but this gun I've got pointed at just says you can.
Is that mine?
Afraid so. Sorry, Lester.
Me too.
24 hours. You have my word.
Who is this?
Police, Mrs. Matthews.
Just a minute. Yes?
Sorry to bother you at this hour, Mrs. Matthews, but is your husband home?
Could I see your identification?
Oh. You mean since I'm not wearing a uniform?
Mm-hmm.
I'm a plainclothes officer. This is my ID card.
May I see it, please? Oh, this says you're a private investigator, Mr. Terrell.
Well, that's true.
What are you doing here?
I'll be frank. Your husband's a client of mine, and I have to see him now.
I'm afraid you can't. Mike's not here.
He's not? Have you seen him at all tonight?
Just for a few minutes. He ran in and ran out. He's closing a business deal.
Well, where'd he go? Do you know?
If I tell you... Can I go with you?
I really don't think you should.
Then I won't tell you.
Wait. All right.
I wrote down the address. I'll get it.
Hurry. I've got a borrowed car.
Tell me, Mr. Terrell, is it standard procedure to hire a private detective to investigate a business associate?
It's common practice.
I see. Then why did you have to get the address from me?
I lost it.
And the police car you drove up in?
I found it.
Mr. Terrell, you don't expect me to believe all this.
It's not very convincing, is it?
Not very. Oh. Oh, what's the matter with this car now?
Better pull over. The engine's overheating.
Oh. Well, what do we do now?
Walk. It's not far from here. Going in alone. Wait here. Mike! Mike, what happened? You're not making yourself clear. Let me get that gag off.
Is
this clear enough, Thompson? Drop the gun. Oh, now I understand. This was a setup. What are you, jerk? A cop?
No, just a jerk.
Where's Maggie?
Who?
The girl you were with. Oh, yeah. Cindy.
How should I know?
Oh, she ain't come back yet. Looks like we all wait together. Sit down next to your friend there. All right, now put your arms in back of you. There.
That's a little tight.
Well, that's the brakes. Very interesting. Steve Terrell, private investigator. Hey, I got something to show you. Don't go away.
Nice going, Mike. You think you're in trouble. I had to steal a patrol car to get here. When are you going to learn not to speak with your mouth full?
Well, the pictures are still in the fixer, but I thought you might want to look at them anyway.
Not bad. A little grainy, but... Hey, did I do that?
You've seen enough, Private Eye.
Oh! I can't see! I'm blind!
Mike!
The gun! Get the gun!
Somebody help me!
Untie these ropes, please.
Oh, Mike, I was so worried.
Oh,
thanks, honey. Where have you been?
Would you put...
Over here,
please.
I was worried sick. I thought you and the boys had been kidnapped.
No, no, they're...
Well, at least put a gag on Pomerantz. I can't stand to hear a grown man cry.
All right, nobody move. Put down the gun, lady.
Hi, Lester.
Hello, Steve. What happened? You get tied up?
Yeah, I got mugged by an insane Boy Scout.
Are you the police?
Yes, ma'am.
Please untie me, Lester.
Who's this?
Name's Pomerantz, I think.
He your client?
No, he's a blackmailer, too.
Mr. Terrell works for me.
What's your name?
Mike Matthews.
You're under arrest, Mr. Matthews.
He didn't do it.
Do what?
Did he? No, I told you, he's a blackmailer. Get me out of this chair.
Steve, you gave me your word you'd deliver the killer.
And I'm good for it. You've only got one guess left.
Who?
Her? You got it. I'd applaud, but I can't.
Diane?
I did it for you, Mike. Yes, I killed that woman.
But why?
I knew you were paying blackmail. The way you've been acting and then the checking account. I've been following you.
You have?
That's how you got my gun, right?
That's right.
You want to know how I figured it out? First you came to the door tonight wearing stockings under your robe. Then I wondered why you'd leave your children alone in an empty house.
Oh.
Then your car. A cold motor doesn't overheat. Then...
That's all, Steve.
No, but there's more.
Sergeant, take him away.
Oh, Lester, how'd you know to come here?
Someone left a note on your office door telling you to meet them here. Must have been Matthews. Gee, that's rough about his wife.
Will you untie me now?
Sure.
Hey, what's the idea? Why the handcuffs?
Sorry, Steve. Got to take in.
What for?
Aggravated assault, grand theft auto, impersonating an officer.
I'm Rod Serling. Close your eyes. Exercise your imagination. And join us again on our next presentation of The Zero Hour.
Wanted, A Willing Companion is an original radio drama adapted by Kim Weisgott. William Shatner was heard as Steve Terrell. Featured in the cast were Keith Walker, Eileen Robbins, Alan Bergman, Julie Bennett, and Sam Edwards. Zero Hour, created by J.M. Collis, directed by Don Hills, is produced in Hollywood for the Mutual Broadcasting System by Radio Productions Incorporated. Music is composed and conducted by Stanley D. Hoffman. Rochelle Sherman, associate producer. This has been a presentation of the Mutual Broadcasting System.